Go measure that side. Measure, you touch them. Measure from here to where I cut it off. That antenna is in shitter garbage, speaking. Can you 3/4 inches? 11 1/4 here, so it'll be alright, I guess. See, a milk nail is doing something on.
Here. lay a 2x4 on the ground too and drill it. Put it back in the screw and pull the drill over. Hey. Looks like you got them all. Put that stuff to the side. Need the drill over there, get the drill. Your screws back up there and put them fenders on. If some screws are used, you might want to get a real drill bit. You can take the nails or screws out of them first. Throw them out in the woods, don't leave them in the driveway. That's why you don't need to do it that way. Don't drop the metal part on the end. Now I gotta do it the way you had it. You're right. Leave it like that. Slide it all the way out to this edge as far as it'll go. Jim. Put it on and line it up.
Once you get it straight, it gives you more opportunity. Right? Go ahead and do it. Right over here. Thank you. What's that?
Thunder's on it.
We're filming. Grab your chair a bit. What'd you say? Thunder's on?
No, we'll get that one.
What'd you say before that? Might be able to hit this back with a big sledgehammer. You got one? Just hold the trailer. Pull the trailer. That's all you need.
Thanks, Joe.
How you doing?
Shwell.
Oh, Shwell with your mom?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that. I thought she was still here. Started that with
just get a screw started in one, then move it around. Gotta put it in the drill first. Start these two first. Now put the screw in the hole. Put the screw in the hole. Just start them first so you can spin the fender where you need it. Get them all started, then tighten them down. You missed. You missed, I think. Take it out. Use the tool.
It won't come out.
Pull it up. Pull the fender. Now put it in the hole. See what's going on under there. Put the screw in the hole.
I missed the hole with the drill while I was doing it.
What do you mean you drill it? What'd you drill through?
It must have went off. I thought it went through.
Well, I asked you if you drilled the holes. You didn't look, see if there's a hole in the metal or what? What the hell is this? Like dollar store construction, or what are you doing over here?
Because you don't listen.
I tell you to put this in there first. No, let's see. Set that stuff down out of the way over there. I did that.
Yep.
Then I put the level here. I lined it up down there with the fender.
Yeah.
And that metal right there, and then I drew a line all the way out. See it?
Yep.
All right. Okay. Now. Cut it off. Here. Now. This thing gets banged up and moved around. I can't trust this. See it? Normally, that one that's got the zero on it should be close to. Right there. See, it is. Start it like this. Come around behind me. Keep this right on this line. You hold it steady. Keep your thumb here. Gonna want to go into the wood, because look here, let me show you. Just until you get started, first half inch or so, you got to pull this up. How could we pinky like this?
Okay.
And once you get in an inch or so, you just let that go and put your pinky back in out of the way. I'll start it for you so you don't have to do that in the first cut. All right, sometimes you start out. On the wood already.
Okay.
So it's started. It gets caught here. Look. In the beginning, they're not made right. They don't want to turn.
Okay.
So now I'm going to go a little bit more. And the reason I did that is so the guide stays up. And look, I pulled you back off of there, because when you first start like that, when it ain't running, it can kick like this. So hold it like. You don't gotta push hard, but hold that fucker like you got a death. Sound like it's screaming and running free like a vacuum cleaner.
If it starts to sound like a vacuum cleaner and it's got clogged hose, or it's starting to suck like it's under load, you're doing something wrong. You're not cutting straight, or you're hitting something you're not supposed to be.
Okay. Maybe I was pushing too hard.
No, you were okay. I was listening. It made a couple noises. I could see you were rocking it, twisting it a little bit. That's all. You can't really turn with it so much like a jigsaw.
Right.
But if you lean one way or the other, or you hit a nail and bend a tooth on the saw, it'll start cutting crooked. I have smooth tools. This is more of that free lumber that Hillbilly got for us from work. It was in the dumpster, old bridge forms. I don't think that matters so much on here.
Because you can hit it going with the rails all the way down.
You just gotta mark the rails so you know where to put. You got a sharpie or something? Soap.
This thing work?
All you gotta do is mark the ribs so we can see where to put the screws. See? Here's the center rib. Now get that into the plywood, help me lift it up so we can see. Just this edge.
Hold it there.
Okay. Here's the rib. You know there's a rib there where the fender is, okay? So, set that down. Now we're just going to put a couple of holes for them. We're going to do big 2x4s with a mold on the edge, right? Put a screw in that hole. Right there. Right there's one. Put it in there. Remember, easy. Don't ram it home. Push. Remember, once you feel it go through the metal, let off the trigger. Still don't even hold it down hard. Good, let go. You might have hit it.
I'm gonna get an infield go through.
Alright, listen. It ain't going nowhere. That's good for now.
Okay.
You gotta bring another piece of wood back here. I think we're only gonna need two like that, okay? Tip it over a little bit more towards the shed. Tip it towards the shed. Now come back.
Oh, I see.
Great light outside the ball. All the way over to the fender. Go right on past the fender. Pull it back towards the garbage this way, towards you. There you go. What's she doing, leaving?
Yeah. Yeah, that belt works. I'll run along with them for a minute. I gotta go get something.
What you gotta go get? Stop this piece of shit, it won't stop.
Next gap
board. So, hold this up here,
you'll hold it.
Hold it on the end
so you can pull the slide down and hold it tight. Now look.
Put it on there. Slide it up more so it's straight because it's not right. Make everything precision and it's still going to be off some, so you don't want to slack off on the measurements. It's all screwy looking. Alright?
Okay.
Nothing's perfect, so you try to be as close as you can and it'll be okay when you're done. Good enough, good enough. It's not going to be good enough when you put all the good enough pieces together. They're going to come up a little bit short.
So you make
everything's going to be off.
So you make all the pieces perfect and you'll get good enough.
Try it for it. You shoot for perfection, but you're never going to achieve it. So put this on there. Catch them marks.
I don't see the marks.
Other side of the level. Hold this down. And then it'll follow you. Otherwise, you can just wrap it around and unplug it halfway. See the mark with the zero?
Yep.
See what I said about your cord?
Yep.
Throw your cord off of there. Pull the saw back a half inch and start again. Wait till the saw's up to speed before you start trying to cut, all right? should have a brush. Don't brush it with your hand, you're gonna get splinters. Now throw your cord around here and cut the same way you did before. Keep throwing the wood, come around this way and cut that way.
Okay.
You're doing good. Just don't try to rush. You're trying to go a little too fast. There's no rush. You want to race, get your track shoes on and run. Show the viewers at home what screws we're going to use there. These are the screws we're going to use. And these are what we're going to use to hold some 2x4s down, not the plywood. We're using ones that are about 1.5 inches long. These are 3 inches and an eighth, 3 1/8 inches long. We need to hold the 2x4s down. That to the side. Line your wood up. The reason we got those long ones is because we're going to shoot right down through a 2x4, through this plywood, and right into the steel frame of the trailer. And the screw's got a little drill bit on the end that steel, the drills through the steel frame of the trailer.
Lift it up, go past it,
okay.
And then take your fingers out. Now pull it back. Look, help me. Now pull it back. Now push it in tight. Bend down so you don't pinch your fingers.
Let's put a couple short ones in the hole back. See these? We're using some of these to hold the plywood in. They're just old, rusted ones that held the old plywood in. It rotted off.
That for now.
come with a little plastic bag with the right size bit you're going to need for the application of the screw. Call me, Jim. Cut some boards. Put a 2x4 in here. Got a piece you cut off?
Yes, right here.
Another piece that fell off in the back under the trailer in the 2x4 to block. Pass that metal, there you go. Let go now. I think we should cut it back for a minute. Like just start. I think this is what we should do. This is
this off. Alright, we need the other piece. That way the seam is there behind the fender, out of sight, out of the way, and it's stronger than if you put a little piece there a couple inches. Okay. You see what I'm saying?
Yep.
Here you never pick this up.
This will take some tires up.
Paid a lot of money for that, remember?
Okay, so
cut that. Bring it back here out of the way where you've been cutting. Lay it on top. Set your cord up so you don't get tangled. Make sure you don't cut the cord too. You wouldn't be the first person to do it. Always make sure it's out of your way.
Those holes can keep them closed.
You can't hold that side when you hold it. Look, it's going to spin, so put it against there is when you start. Alright. You want to see a trick I used to do? Here. When I was younger like you and didn't have the greatest coordination with tools, and I was working by myself, sometimes you need three hands. Just put a screw in here. And then when you're done, you just take the screw out and reuse it. But now it won't move. You gotta watch, I keep tripping on this. Look, this is supposed to be right there. Right back in the same hole you just used. Thank you. measure one there.
Okay. Where's that piece that just cut off?
Too short.
It might be high enough for the upright, you know? Give me the other. Just drill the pilot hole for the screw again, that's all. Give him the light, you measure the board. One more to you.